Hello friends, my name is B.K. Kollapure. Today we will see how to draw the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram for an overhanging beam. In earlier videos, we have seen how to find out the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram for simply supported beam with different load combinations, concentrated load, UDL load, UVL load and moment. So today we will see how to draw SFD and BMD for an overhanging beam. Suppose this is a simply supported beam. If this is subjected to load, then the beam is going to bend in this form, whether it is UDL or concentrated load. This is the type of bending. So this type of bending, we call it as sagging bending moment, where this is the deflection here and moment here is zero, moment here is zero, because it is simply supported. Suppose if I take a overhanging beam, these two are the supports and this part is the overhanging part. If I subject this to the loading, any form of loading, then this bending of the beam, so from here to here, this will be sagging and some part will be hogging and this will remain straight. So here, in this case of beam overhanging, here it is simply supported, definitely moment is zero. But if you see here at the overhanging support, moment is not zero, whereas the moment will be hogging moment. See, this is sagging moment and here this is also sagging, but here it is hogging. Hogging moment is nothing but the negative bending moment. Sagging moment we take it as positive, hogging we take it as negative. Just let me show this with a model here. Suppose if I support the beam like this, on the two supports, it is simply supported and it is carrying load. If I apply the load to this beam, it is bending in the downward direction. So this is as good as the sagging moment. Suppose if I hold the beam like this. Now you see, this part is simply supported, whereas this is the overhanging part. If I apply the load here, so this is getting sagging, whereas this is getting lifted. Suppose if I apply load here, as well as a load here. Now you see the pattern of the bending, what you are seeing is same. So here at this point it is sagging and here at this point at the support it is hogging. So this is bending down, here it is bending up. So bending down is sagging or positive, bending up is negative or hogging bending moment. So in case of overhanging moment beam, the moment at the overhanging portion is not zero, it is always negative, what you call it as a hogging bending moment. If it is simply supported, then moment will be zero. Suppose if I take a beam overhanging on both the sides, then the bending pattern will be like this, then it will be like this. So here it is hogging at the support, sagging at the supports, it is hogging. In this case, at both the supports, moment will not be zero because the overhanging part and the moment will be negative bending moment. So this hint you'll have to take whenever you go for design of overhanging beam. At the overhanging part, there will be moment acting which is negative bending moment. So today we'll see that with a simple example to draw the bending moment diagram and shear force diagram for an overhanging beam. Suppose this is a beam. It is having support at A and another support at B. Now see, this is the overhanging part here. Suppose this is subjected to a UDL from one end to the other end, C if I call this. In addition, if there is a concentrated load acting here, 15 kilonewton, and if I take this UDL as 10 kilonewton per meter, and if this length of the beam or the span is 6 meters, and this overhanging part, if I take it as 1.5 meters. So you are required to draw the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram for this. This is a simply supported beam. So first step is to find out the reactions. So we'll find out the reactions. So to find reactions, sigma V must be 0. That is, upward reactions RA plus RB must be equal to the downward load acting. This UDL is from here to here. So total UDL will be 10 into 6 plus 1.5. So this will be 7.5. So 10 into 7.5 plus there is a concentrated load here 15. So this will be equal to 90 kilonewton. So if I take moment about A and equate it to 0, I'm taking moment about A. RB, its perpendicular distance is 6 meters. It is rotating in anti-clockwise, so minus. Then coming to this UDL, 10 into 7.5 is the total load acting. It will act at the center of 7.5. So this will be equal to plus 10 into 7.5. It will be acting at the center of 7.5. Plus we'll go to this concentrated load, 15 into its perpendicular distance is 6 plus 1.5, 7.5 is equal to 0. So if you simplify again, you get RB will be equal to 65.63 kN. And if you substitute this here, RA will be equal to 24.37 kN. So this is the first step you'll have to do. So you get here RA is equal to 24.37 and RB at the support B will be equal to 65.63. So once you find out these reactions, then we'll go for the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. So let us take a portion AB. So I'll consider a section X1 at a distance X from the left end. So shear force at X1. So sign convention again, left up, right down, shear force is positive and left up, right up, moment is positive. Now I'm taking left hand side, 24.37, left up is positive, 24.37 minus 10, it is acting for a distance of x, 10 into x, it is varying with x by a linear equation. So we substitute x is equal to 0 to x is equal to this end is 6 meters. So if x is 0, shear force at x at A will be equal to 24.37 kN. When x is equal to 6 meters, shear force at C will be equal to minus 35.63. kilonewton, minus 35.63 kilonewton. If I plot that here, here it is 24.37. Now at B it is minus 35. So minus means go down here, 35.63. You'll have to join these two by straight line. And see here, the shear force is changing from positive to negative. Whenever this happens, you should find out where is the point where the shear force is zero. Because I have taken x from here, we should locate this distance. To locate this distance, we will equate fx is equal to 0. So 24.37 minus 10 into x is equal to 0. So x will be equal to 2.437 meters from A. So this distance will be 2.437 meters. So we got the point where the shear force is zero. Now, next we'll come to the bending moment. M at X1 is equal to, we have two forces, up moment is positive, 24.37 into X. 24.37 into X. Then this force is 10 into X. It is acting at a distance of x by 2 and x by 2. I want this distance. So 10 into x by 2. Down is negative. So this will be 10 into x by 2. So this will be equal to 24.37x minus 5x square. This is parabolic because x is to the power of 2 here. Now let's substitute the limits. X is equal to 0. Then moment will be 0 because it is simply supported. And when x is equal to 6 meters, moment at B will be equal to, if I substitute the values here, so 24.37 into 6 minus 5 into 6 square. You get here, bending moment will be minus 33.75 kilonewton meter. So if I draw the bending moment diagram, so here moment is 0, whereas at this B, moment is down, negative, because it is minus 33.75. It is going down. Now, if I want to join these two points, I'll have to join by a parabola. Now, here, we are getting a point where shear force is zero. So, this moment can't be the maximum bending moment. So, maximum bending moment must be where shear force is equal to zero. So, if I substitute x is equal to, where it is zero, 2.437 into 2 is our bending moment equation. If I substitute here, we get M max will be equal to 29.69 kilonewton meter, and that value is positive, means from here you mark a point, this will be 29.69 kilonewton meter. Now we'll have to join these three points by a parabola. If I draw a parabola here, see, this is Hawking moment, negative bending moment you are getting. So, this part is positive moment. Now, here again, the bending moment is changing sign from positive to negative. So, here moment is zero. We call this point as point of contraflexure. Point of contraflexure is a point where bending moment is zero. We should locate what is this distance where the bending moment is zero. These are all the salient points what we will finding out. To find out this distance, moment is zero here, let us equate equation 2 to 0, that is bending moment equation to 0, then we get the value 24.37 into x minus 5x square is equal to 0. If you simplify this, you get x will be equal to 4.874 meters from A, because we have taken the distance from A. So, this distance will be 4.87 meters. Now, this is the shear force and bending moment diagram in the portion A to B. Suppose if I go to portion, next portion. This is a cantilever portion. Very easily you can look at the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. If you see at this point, if I take you consider x2, we know it's a cantilever part. In case of cantilever, we consider the distance x from the free end. Suppose if I take the section here, shear force at x2 is equal to, it is right down is positive. So 15. And this distance will be 10 is the UDL, it is acting for a distance of x down again plus 10x. So x is equal to 0 to x is equal to 1.5 meters. So shear force at C will be equal to 15 kilonewton, and shear force at B, this will be equal to 30 kilonewton. 30 kilonewton, and both are positive here. So if I draw a line here, this is going up 30 kilonewton and this is going up 15 kilonewton. So I'll have to join these two by a linear, because x is to the power of 1. So this is a positive shear force diagram. Similarly, if I take moment at the section, it will be 15 into x down, moment is negative, and UDL is also there, 10 into x. It will act at the center, x by 2 and x by 2 into x by 2 minus. So here, this will be minus 15x minus 5x square. This is a parabola. So let us substitute the limit x is equal to 0. Moment at C will be equal to 0 because it's a cantilever, and at the free end of the cantilever, bending moment is always 0. So here, when x is equal to 1.5 meter, here this point, so moment will be equal to minus 33.75 kilonewton meter. This is moment at x is equal to B, MB. We are getting moment at MB, and at MB we already got a moment of minus 33.75. This is checked for your calculation. So this is these are the points that will have to connect. Now the nature of curve is a parabolic curve, so let us join these two by a parabola. This is a negative, so this is the shear force diagram and this is your bending moment diagram. Now salient points you see here, whenever you change the shear force from positive to negative, determine the point where the shear force is zero, and at that point you get the bending moment is maximum. And if you plot the bending moment curve, if the bending moment curve is passing from positive to negative, locate the distance of the point of contour fracture where moment is zero, and at the simplest support moment is zero, shear force is maximum. Where shear force is zero, bending moment is maximum. At the overhanging part, you get negative bending moment. It is a hogging bending moment. And at the free end of a cantilever beam, bending moment is zero. These are the points which you will have to remember while solving the problems. So we'll take up another problem in the next video. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos. Press the bell icon for notifications. Comment for questions in the question section or the comment section. Thank you.